Boxing superstar Gervonta Tank Davis, 29-0, 27 knockouts. 29-0, 27 knockouts. Considered by many the face of boxing. And if it's not Tank, it's Canelo. Considered by many the pound-for-pound king. And if it's not Tank, it's either Canelo or Crawford or Inouye. But Tank is up there from a young kid growing up in a very rough environment through the system from West Baltimore. He's given me a tour. He showed me where, like, the chief of police was attacked in his own neighborhood, where the police said, you know, we don't even care. We're not coming. That's where Tank started. It was him, Coach Calvin, Coach Kenny, Russ, Lauren. Now, of course, he has Michi. His brother has always been there. But Michi, and he has 6'4", and Ali. But it's so great to see someone beating the odds and becoming from a person that no one believed in, except his team. And you got to give Floyd a shout out, too. He's a big help as well. But his team believed in him when the whole world didn't. I remember Tank, when he was 9-0, 10-0, he came to Vegas. It was a big fight. And he was in media center, and he was trying to get the media to interview him. And none of the media would interview him. They didn't believe in him. They were talking smack. They said, this kid's not going nowhere. They were busy looking up what nightclub to go to or what restaurant to order food from. They gave him the cold shoulder. And I think that's the wrong philosophy. Anytime. Who doesn't have 2 minutes to interview a fighter? Could change their life. Doesn't hurt you. If you're a reporter, give someone some shine. It could change their life. Could change their day. And what's 2 minutes? Don't try to interview Canelo in his prime. Don't try to interview Mayweather in his prime. Don't try to interview all these guys where you could have helped them. I remember interviewing Ryan Garcia when he was 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, way before he was Ryan Garcia. I interviewed Tank before it was popular. I remember a lot of these superstars, Manny Pacquiao, before he had his big break and beat De La Hoya, and then the rest is history. But sometimes you don't have a choice. You're not going to meet like someone. But if you have a chance and someone's near you, don't only say you only interview superstars. Give some amateurs some shine. Give people shine. I think I've always had the philosophy of helping everybody from the get-go. And some people will make it, some people won't. I remember interviewing David Benavidez when he was 10 years old. And now look at him. He's fighting against Boo Boo coming up. It's a very big fight. Benavidez, Mexican monster. Boo Boo is tremendously talented as well. That's November 25th. But back to Tank. A lot of options for him. A lot of options. You heard Manny Pacquiao, the only 8th division champion in boxing, say that he's interested in fighting Tank. Big compliment for Tank. There's the Shakur fight down the line. There's a rematch with Ryan. There's a rematch with Pitbull Cruz. There's Derek James has a very talented 135-pounder as well. Frank Martin, that's a potential opponent. And then you have Ryu, and you have so many fighters, anybody, 30, 35, 40, 47. Tank can fight anybody. A fight with him and Tio, a fight with him, a rematch with Rolly. Rolly's a champion now. So, by the way, this is Tank, and he's repping that ES News shirt. Shout out to Tank. Always showing love, always showing loyalty. You can't buy loyalty. And it's all genuine. Some people, it's all business. Some people are just being good people. Tank never talks trash, never goes out of his way to make anyone look bad. He'll answer if people go after him, but he doesn't take the initiative. And people love Tank. 11 sellouts in a row. No disrespect to any fighter, but he fought Hector Garcia. Not the biggest name in boxing, talented fighter. It was his birthday yesterday. Happy birthday, Hector. And Tank had the best gate in DC history. Best gate in DC history, better than any rock group, Guns N' Roses, and all that. And then you have him and Ryan. 5th biggest gate in Vegas history, in the entire history of boxing in Vegas, Tank and Ryan. And Ryan's popular, Tank's popular, and together they did it. And think about the pay-per-views. 6th best pay-per-view ever in an era where everyone steals pay-per-views. So if people didn't steal pay-per-view, I predicted that fight will do 3 and 4 million buys. So you figure Tank and Ryan did 1.3 million. Tyson Fury and Ngannou did 11,500. And another 55,000 on ESPN thing. So 65,000 for Fury and Ngannou. And Fury's supposed to be famous. I'm not a fan of Fury or his style. Ngannou is famous in the MMA world. Everybody knows him. But that fight just didn't was missing something. Gervonta Davis could fight anyone. He could fight me and it would sell. That's how good, that's how big he is. So can't wait to see. It's coming up early next year. And he's putting in the work right now. He always stays ready. He says, I have to get ready. I remember getting ready for Ryan Garcia. He went to a Laker game that same night at midnight. He was in the gym from midnight to 5 a.m. Midnight to 5 a.m. working his ass off getting ready. He worked so hard. Nobody knew. He was, what did they say? People move in silence. So Ryan worked hard as well. But Tank has work ethics. And whatever he worked on in the gym is what he did in the fight. Just, you know, his team are very, very high level. Calvin, like I said, Kenny, Lauren, Russ, and everybody. So excited to see what's next for Tank. Can't wait. And there you have it. We'll keep you guys posted the second we're here. Gervonta Tank Davis. Can't wait to see him back in the ring. Ellie Setback reporting.
Ellie Setback reporting. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Setback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Setback reporting.